And it's very much, about that cycle of destruction. I mean, it's easy to take a different meaning to it. Many people can define it because it's simple. But for me, it was based on relationships and how a person can constantly have this cycle of destruction and then finally be confronted with something that is that ultimately stops you in your tracks.
Last but not least, being a musician, I have to ask about your music choice. I don't know if you could talk about how you found it, what it means to you, and so on.
Sure.
Well, when I looked at music, I was looking for something very scratchy, something with a lot of texture. So I looked at a lot of phonographic old recordings, and I stumbled upon Viola Brown's recording. She's a completely unknown gospel singer from South Carolina from the 30s. And she recorded three or four songs on a phonograph. And I found this at the Library of Congress. And then I contacted the person who owns it, and I bought it from him. And it's part of a 40 or 50 set of old phonograph recordings, all gospel music, all about Satan, and all these wonderful lyrics that are really, really relevant to the story of this film.
Does anyone have any questions that they want to ask? Speak up, your man.
So did you start out with this idea and then work with it, or did you find the music? I know you said you found the music for it, but did you find the music and then animate with it, or did you animate first and then find music and
No, I found the music after I made the film. The film was, I was working on another project, and the idea of someone's head fitting into a wall was kind of the impetus for the film. So I think I was halfway into animating the film when sometimes you just have to stop drawing and do some audio. And that's when I started doing research about music. I also, for a second, I had a musician working on it, and it just wasn't clicking. So about halfway through, I stumbled upon Viola's song. Yeah. Any other questions?